Hey guys, hey, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, what's up? My name is Nassine. I have been doing keto for just over a year now. I've lost almost 90 pounds and we all have our ups and downs on this journey. Today, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about mine. So if you are new here, I do meal preps on occasion. It's been a while, reviews, things like that. So today is a vlog. I do vlogs every day, but I also do things here and there. You're like, get on with it. Okay, I'm getting on with it. Yesterday was my daughter's birthday. As you know, there's a sickness going through my house, hand, foot, and mouth disease. I'm home today. Today is Monday. I am home today. I took another vacation day because I started getting a sore throat last night, and I don't want to bring it to work because that's the first sign of it. So I don't know. I've had some strange feelings in my hands, and I'm like, is it it? I don't know. I don't know. So, you know, I'm just being cautious. There's people at work that have little kids, grandbabies, they're elderly, whatever. You know, that's not something you want going through work. So I stayed home. Anyways, yesterday was my daughter's birthday and I made her a cake, and then a friend dropped off a cake for her, and I gave in. I gave in to the temptation of cake. I decided I wanted to have some cake. I was gonna enjoy a slice of cake for her birthday, and then that was gonna be it. However, that slice of cake turned into another slice of cake, who then turned into, it was that slice of cake, and then the other cake came, and my daughter's like, well, since you already had one, this cake's really good. It's the best cake ever, and you need to try it. And I'm like, no, I'm not even hungry. Oh, you have to try it. And I'm like, and then I gave in and I had that cake, and then I had another cake later, and then I had another cake. I think I had like 4 pieces of cake, and then I had one of the enlightened ice creams. I think that's all I had besides for what I recorded and showed you guys. I didn't eat anything else that was like not keto, just the cake. Nope, I had a fruit roll up. Yep, I had a fruit roll up and a juice box, which tasted disgusting. I was like off the rails because I knew that I was kicked, and hey, why not just get it all out of your system? And that's such a bad idea to do because it leaves you feeling like crap, mentally, physically, everything. So my last weigh-in, I weighed 225 and my lowest is 222. I've said it before, I'm always at my lowest weight at the beginning of the month or towards the end of the month, and it's whenever after I have my period, that's my lowest weight. So I know I've been maintaining around a 223 to a 225 all month so far, and the end of January. And so after all the cake in the world and the fruit roll up and the juice box, I weighed myself this morning, which I was very scared to, and I weighed 228.6. So that's what one night of food can do to you, you know. Bad decision. I immediately had a headache after the third bite of the cake, and I should have known then, like, hey, stop. But I was like, I'm already in now. So today I'm about to show you my breakfast. I am trying to not really worry about protein and fat too much today. I am just trying to keep myself full on keto foods so I don't give in to those sugar cravings, because I will have sugar cravings today. I will. I still have a headache right now, and I almost feel a little nauseous. I just made my breakfast, but I'm still hungry at the same time. It's such a weird feeling. So I made some eggs. I made 4 eggs with 36 grams of mozzarella cheese, 28 grams of spinach, and then I chopped up 4 sausage links and mixed that in, salt and pepper. That's my breakfast. I have my cup of coffee, the white Russian with a little splash of Tarani vanilla bean, and my scoop of the chocolate collagen, and I made 2 burger patties for later for lunch. So I'm hoping that I can just keep my eye on the prize and get right back into ketosis. I don't have any strips for my Keto Mojo, which is my preferred way to test my ketones and my blood glucose, but I do have my keto scan, the breath scanner. So I will be scanning my breath later because I've already drank something, and you can't do it for like 30 minutes after. So I just wanted to be honest with you guys and give you guys an update and let you guys know that you are definitely not alone. We all make mistakes. We all fall off. There's not one person out there that can say, no, I have never cheated on my diet ever. Well, I mean, maybe there is, but it's very rare. You know, we've all had a mistake here and there, and you might have done well for 2 years straight and then eaten one tiny little cracker or licked a lollipop. I don't know, but you know what? I'm just trying to be real and honest here, and I am being honest with you guys. And this doesn't mean that I'm just off the wagon and done with keto. No, keto is a lifestyle, and it was my daughter's birthday, and it wasn't planned, which usually if I go off plan, it is definitely a planned thing, like a holiday or a birthday. Now, I have frosting on my hand. Where the heck did that come from? That's weird. Now, I'm caught red-handed or blue-handed. Now, I plan at Thanksgiving or Christmas or my boyfriend's birthday, like next weekend, we're going out to eat, but I think I'm gonna stay keto just because I didn't stay keto this time around. But anyways, those are planned. Keto is a lifestyle, just as if you would go enjoy cake at a birthday party or drinks on a night out with friends. It's not something you do every night. You go back to your regular lifestyle afterwards. That's how I look at it. Now, if you are on a strict regimen and you are trying to lose weight, etc., that may not be in what you want to do. But once you reach your goal weight and you are comfortable and you're in that zone where, yes, this is a lifestyle for you, and you're not in a race to lose weight anymore, which I don't feel like I'm in a race to lose weight anymore. Yes, I love losing the weight, but I'm not racing because I know that this is a choice that I've made. This is the lifestyle that I've made. This is what I'm always going to eat. I will always be keto and I will always eat this way unless somehow I'm forced to not eat this way due to some sort of medical reason. This is my life now and I will always go back to this. So this is the lifestyle, and I gotta go wash my hand because I keep looking at it and I'm like, rah. All right, guys, so I'm on my second cup of coffee. This is another White Russian. This one just has a splash of the vanilla and unsweetened almond milk, and then I did make a Zip Fizz. I think this is grape. Yep, grape. I have a killer headache, and I'm not hungry, but my mind is telling me that I need to eat all the things, and I'm not. I'm gonna fight, and I'm gonna stay strong. So, and this is gonna be a battle today. I'm going to be battling myself. Especially with this headache, it is really frustrating. So I just sat down at my computer. I have a video that I edited. I just need to upload it. Actually, I have a couple of videos that I added. I actually have a few videos that I did do some editing on, and I just need to upload them and make a thumbnail. So that's what I'm gonna do now. Here's that two burger patties that I cooked this morning, and I just put a piece of provolone cheese in the middle, some sugar-free ketchup and mustard, and some pickles. This is lunch. It's about 3:15, and I'm having some major cravings for sugar. So this is three hard-boiled eggs with a tablespoon of mayo and some mustard, salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder. I'm gonna have a little bit of egg salad. Gotta try to keep these away. This is also my second Zip Fizz because my head is pounding.
The next day.
And as you can see, I am home again. I am going back to work tomorrow. I took another vacation day today. Just, I wasn't feeling my 100, and yeah, so I weighed in this morning at 228.2. I think it's only down just almost a pound, but not completely. Link is like, what the heck? Link is all up in the place. So it's 9 a.m. and I've been awake since the boys went to school at like 7:30, and I made my coffee, but I've only had a couple of sips and I haven't eaten anything. I'm not hungry. I'm gonna hold off eating. I think he has to go to the bathroom, so I'm gonna let him outside, and when I do eat something, I will show you. Okay, so it's 10:30. I have two pickle spears chopped up in this. This is about 200 grams of ground beef that I seasoned with some burger seasoning, about 20 grams of spinach, one serving of sugar-free ketchup, a serving of the honey mustard from G. Hughes, and then one tablespoon of mayonnaise, and four cherry tomatoes. No breakfast today, just going right to lunch. So I just went to go make my kids some chicken wings and my air fryer. And my air fryer is like broken. I don't know what happened to it. It worked fine the last time I used it. So that really sucks. Anybody know anything about air fryers? I'm gonna have to Google. I don't understand what's going on. I turn it on, it starts to run, but it's really quiet and doesn't sound normal. And then it just shuts off. It's not the plug. I don't know. Darn the day. All right, guys, this is my lunch. 2 slices of the zero net carb bread from Aldi, 1 serving of Black Forest ham, 1 ounce of salami, 2 slices of provolone cheese, and then about 7 pieces of the jalapeno parm crisp from Aldi. And then this is 2 servings. I'm gonna have 1. These are so good, these chili roasted. There's about 2.5 servings in here. And it's 6 total carbs with 3 fiber. These are delicious. They are very, very, very good. Very addicted. And gonna have this cherry limeade.